If you are a Samsung user and you are a fan of customization, then you have probably heard about Samsung Goodlock. It's an app that brings a ton of customization features for practically everything in one UI. Now Goodlock is only available in 5 countries, so we will be using the alternate solution, which is NiceLog. Hey everyone, this is Sherry, welcome back to my channel, and today we will be talking about MultiStar from the Goodlock series. Let's start with the MultiStar. First, download NiceLog from Play Store, and then you have to install all of the modules separately by downloading their APKs. Now for MultiStar, I would say that it's for hardcore power users that take multitasking very seriously. With this app, you can easily create pop-up windows and enhance your split screen experience. Okay, so once you are in MultiStar, you will see a few options over here, and I will show you each and every one that can affect your usage. Okay, so first we have settings for Samsung Dex. In here we can see three options. First is the high resolution for external displays. Now Dex already works pretty fine on default resolution, but if you want to get more out of it, you can use this one as well. But that option also causes the device to heat up, so use it with caution. Next, we can open up more than 5 apps at the same time with this option. Again, if you do too much multitasking on your smartphone, this option is for you. Then with the last option, we can auto open the app from the last session. This option is also really helpful to keep track of your work while in Dex mode. Next we have is a quick launch of multi-window. Now we have two types of multi-window here. One is a split screen and the other one is pop-up view. If you enable this, you can see both options. When this option is turned off by default and you tap on recent keys, you will see all of the recent apps that are open right now. Now enable this option and split screen view is selected. Once we tap and hold on to the recent keys button, our app will automatically open in split screen view. Now if we select pop-up view and then tap and hold on to the recent keys button, then the app we are using right now will open up in the pop-up view screen. Next option is multi-window screen zoom. Before this update, this option was only available for pop-up view, but after the update, we can use it with both split screen and pop-up view. What this option does is that it will reduce the size of the screen and try to adjust more content on the screen. Let me show you how that works. The options is turned off, and if I press and hold on to launch multi-window, you can see the size of the content on the screen takes more space. But once I turn this option on and go back into multi-window mode, you can see that we have more content on the screen now. So what it does is that it creates more space on the screen by shrinking down the content. Next we have multi-focus. So let's say you have multi-window mode on and you're working on one app and the other one is just open, and after some time it times out or automatically closes itself. Now multi-focus prevents the app from doing that while in the multi-window view. Remove blur effect on adjusting split view. This one is pretty simple. When you are adjusting screen sizes in multi-window, you can see both apps will blur out, so you can easily arrange them. But in some cases you might not want that. Like maybe you have a video open on YouTube and you're also taking notes from it, and you want to adjust the multi-window to the height of the video. With this option, you can remove the blur effect and easily adjust the multi-window. In pop-up view actions, you can actually set an app to be in the pop-up view, so it pops out of where the main screen is, and then you can have it floating around on the screen. And here you can actually set the size of the gestures that you want to open the screen in pop-up view. So for example, let me set up the biggest size, and now if I swipe diagonally from top right or top left, the screen will open in pop-up view. And here we go, we got our screen in the pop-up view. Now I think the gesture size should be smaller because it would cause the notification panel to open while swiping down on the screen. And we can also change the pop-up view minimization. Next up we have app size stretch to camera hole. When you open this up, on the bottom you can see two options. In aspect ratio, we can see the apps which won't open in full screen by default, so you can set them to open in full screen. Second option is for camera cutout. Here you can set these settings for each app, whether to show camera cutout or hide camera cutout with a black bar on the top. And at the end we have two options that are now moved into the advanced features lab. In here we can force open all apps in multi-window and full screen in split screen view. So I guess that's it for this video. For more customization videos, subscribe to my channel and like this video. See you in the next one. We'll be right back.